Šta će pokretati automobile u budućnosti? Mnogi tvrde električna energija. Nehajući za to što treba da instaliramo hiljade punjača i zagadimo planetu pokušavajući da proizvedemo dodatnu električnu energiju. Neki, kao što je Toyota, ali ne samo Toyota, tvrde da je rešenje vodonik, odnosno automobili koje pokreće struja proizvedena u gorivnim ćelijama. Gde je razlika i ko će pobediti u toj borbi? Možda najbolje zna čovek koji je više od 10 godina vodio razvoj gorivnih ćelija upravo u Toyoti.
Basically, the hydrogen is one of the energy carrier. And it can be the totally full, so zero emission. And also the battery EV or also fuel cell EV could be the future vehicle to relay the zero emission. But I suppose battery has several issues. Probably if the capacity of the battery is increased, that it could be heavier and the charging time will be increased. So for the small vehicle and the short distance driving vehicle, it's battery EV is suitable, I suppose. But for the larger vehicle and long distance vehicle, so but anyway, so hydrogen fuel cell vehicle is required. It's my personal opinion.
Prvi automobil sa gorivnim ćelijama u istoriji bio je DAF 44 iz 1967. Mnogi su potom pokušali da stignu do serijske proizvodnje, ali je malo ko uspeo da odmakne dalje od probnih serija. Toyota je prva još pre 5 godina, bez ograničenja i specijalnih ugovora, u slobodnoj prodaji od Japana do Amerike ponudila Mirai, automobil čiji smo prototip vozili još 2013. a onda u godinama koje slede krstarili njime širom sveta. Upravo Mirai ovih dana nas je doveo u Veliku Britaniju i pokazao kako vodonik može da promeni čitavo društvo, a ne samo automobile.
For the future, if we need to reduce the CO2 drastically more than 80% or 90%, well, firstly, the power plant so need to use so zero emission CO2, so hydrogen, and also the other the chemical plants so required to use but this kind of hydrogen. But unfortunately, the cost of hydrogen is a little bit high for the moment, well, compared to natural gas or coal. So from the viewpoint of the cost, probably the automobile. It will be the first step to use the hydrogen. And secondly, we hope to apply this to the power plant or chemical industries.
Da podsjetimo, gorivna ćelija radi tako što se sa jedne strane iz rezervoara automobila dovodi vodonik, a sa druge kiseonik iz vazduha. Oni reaguju proizvodeći električnu energiju koja pokreće automobil. Izduvnih gasova nema, već iza automobila ostaje čista voda. Dovoljno čista da smo je svojevremeno i popili.
Hydrogen fuel cell technology could be possible for the future and we are ready to start. So we already started, not just waiting. So it's very important, so motivation for us to promote the hydrogen fuel cell. Even if the hydrogen technology is rather difficult compared to the battery technology. So we can promote, and if necessary, we can supply a fuel cell system or technology to the other OEMs. It's fine for us. We have an individual contract between the OEM and the Toyota, but basically, we would be open. But the time limit is not yet decided. But anyway, my personal opinion, during the coming 5 to 10 years, it is not the competition era, but also the collaboration era. So until the fuel cell product is in the world, so we will be open this kind of patents.
Zanimljivo je da Toyota polaže velike nade u razvoj kamiona i autobusa na vodonik, a evo i zašto.
For example, the 40-ton truck requires almost 9 tons of battery. But in case of probably fuel cell, probably the weight is around 1 ton, almost 1/10 compared to the battery. And the charging time of the battery is huge. Even if they use as a quick charger, it takes more than 1 or 2 hours. But for the hydrogen, it takes just 5 or 10 minutes.
I dok Toyota radi na razvoju svojih projekata, maštoviti inženjeri gorivnu ćeliju kao izvor bešumne i čiste energije počinju da koriste na vrlo neobične načine.
You have the fuel cell module with the stack in the middle that's producing you your power. Connected onto a drone with a cylinder, you've got something that's a similar weight to a battery, maybe even a little bit lighter than a battery. But what you've got is a greater energy density. So you're carrying more kilowatt hours actually on the drone, so therefore you can keep the drone in the air much longer. So to give an example, one of the smallest cylinders we supply, which is a 1.44 litre cylinder, coupled with a 650 watt fuel cell, will give you around about 60 minutes flight time. compare that to 15 minutes on an M100, you can see you've got four times that flight time and therefore improved operational efficiencies.
So what we've decided as a company as AJC, we've decided to integrate the fuel cell system with hydrogen, supplying the fuel cell to give us clean emissions and zero noise pollution. What we've done as a product is we've created a battery bank which is powered by solar, which is on the top of the cabins, which is constantly charging your battery bank. And then we've also got a fuel cell with a hydrogen setup to actually be a secondary charger for your battery bank.
Evo i ovo je dobar primjer. Umjesto bučnog agregata koji dimi na sve strane, gorivne ćelije proizvode struju za rasvetu, ali i druge potrebe, kao što je recimo ova stanica za bežični internet, koja bi sa običnom baterijom radila danima, a sa vodonikom nedeljama. Zahvaljujući ovoj tehnologiji, u autoindustriju ulaze čak i novi igrači.
This car is run on a hydrogen fuel cell. It's got four in-wheel motors as well, and we've got regenerative braking. So when you brake, we capture that in some supercapacitors, which then help you to accelerate. That means we can have an 8.5 kilowatt fuel cell. So that's about the power of three domestic kettles. The car is designed out of carbon fiber, as you can see as well. It's incredibly lightweight, so it weighs 600 kilograms. This, again, all this lightweighting enables us to have a fully efficient car. So this car can do 300 mile range on a 250 mile per gallon equivalent. So that's a highly efficient car.
Malo po malo gorivna ćelija i vodonik odomaćili su se u vozovima, a odnedavno i u jednom brodu. Ovo je Energy Observer. Pronašli smo ga usidrenog odmah ispod čuvenog londonskog mosta i iz prve ruke saznali da deo energije za plovidbu proizvodi sam. Prečišćava morsku vodu, zatim elektrolizom dobija vodonik i njime napaja gorivne ćelije koje pokreću elektromotore. Dodatni izvor energije su novi solarni paneli koji upijaju svetlost i sa gornje i sa donje strane. Sve to zajedno znači da brod može gotovo beskonačno da plovi bez ulaska u luku. Istina, samo brzinom do 5 čvorova, jer ako krene brže, potrošnja vodonika će ga ipak naterati da ode na pumpu.
So already battery EV is existing in the world. So unfortunately, the introduction of the phase 3 EV is 5 or 6 years later behind compared to the battery EV. So for the moment, already there are a lot of battery EV and battery players existing in the world. So we need to increase the number of the players of the hydrogen fuel cell for the future. If within 5 to 10 years, there are a number of the fuel cell and hydrogen players existing, probably around 2030 or 25. So I hope the battery EV and hydrogen fuel cell vehicle will be coexist. So after 2025, I personally believe so cost of fuel cell system is compatible for the batteries. Well, to compete with conventional gasoline or diesel vehicle, it's not so easy for both the battery EV or FCB. It probably takes 10 or 20 years, but in the future we need to achieve this target.
Da sve ovo nije samo eksperiment, potvrđuje podatak da velike kompanije poput Shella, OMV-a ili Totala ubrzano grade stanice za točenje vodonika po čitavoj Evropi. U Njemačkoj ih je već blizu 100, a u Britaniji 20. Ali, iako ostanete bez goriva, to neće biti problem.
This is a hydrogen jerry can, if you will. This one is designed for emergency refueling if you are stranded in a hydrogen vehicle. So my company put this together. I actually won an award for this, a Women in Innovation Award, and we're very pleased with it. And we're even more pleased to say that the AA, the Automobile Association, have integrated it into one of their emergency response vehicles. This one is particularly designed for all zero emission vehicles. So they have the hydrogen dispenser at the back. This will buy you about 40 miles if you're stranded en route.
Yeah, basically, of course, the Japanese government and the Californian local government and some of the European countries. And recently, the not so easy, but the Chinese government is a big supporter as also government so viewpoint. And also, there are several supporters such as Shell or some Air Liquide or Inde or Air Products. Some several so energy company is a supporter for us. And also the Hyundai. So recently, they have been a big effort to develop our fuel cell technology, and they already introduced the next new generation Nexo. It's a very nice car, I suppose. So we would like to increase the number of these kinds of support and players in the future.
Clearly, the fossil fuels, the ubiquity and the availability of fossil fuels is not going to go away. The question will be, what direction do you take the drivers and the vehicle owners and operators in, because it's not necessarily about the availability of the fuel, it's also around policy frameworks and guidance towards achieving zero emission transport. And that can be across the spectrum. Some of it will be electric, but increasingly it can also be hydrogen and zero emission hydrogen as well, so green hydrogen. I believe that that transition will be taking place within this decade, and in the same way that by 2040 in the UK, there will be no more internal combustion engines that will be allowed to be sold. We're on that pathway already.